Hello, welcome to ExcelExperts.com. Today's Excel tip is all about moving averages. So suppose you've got a share and you're tracking the share price. So let's say 10 days ago it was 100. It's March 09, credit crunch, so this goes down every day. And I'll do that for 10 days, let's say. Okay. Delete those. So I've got 10 days worth of data. I want to calculate the last X days moving average. So, and I want to be able to input the amount of days for the moving average calculation. So days to average, let's just type 3. So there's a useful function that will return the days of history that we've got already. Days of history. And it's the count function. Count is, it counts the number of cells within a range that are numeric. So in this case, 10. So it ignores the headings and that bit. So that's quite useful. I can enter the whole column. I don't need to adjust the range when I enter a new value. So if I were to copy that down again, this immediately goes to 11. Okay, good. So now I want the moving average. Okay, so clearly I need the average function. Average, Control Shift A brings up that. I'll get rid of this. Now I want to average a range, and I want to define that range using the offset function. Offset allows you to create a new range based on a reference, the number of rows, the number of columns, and the height and the width. So I'm going to offset this value here by the days of history minus the days to average. I'll add 1 to make sure that it's the right amount. Columns, 0. And the height is going to be the days to average. Now, hit enter, and there we go. It's the last 3 days moving average. So let's just prove that that works. Obviously you can't average these three numbers in your head, so let's just minus 10 maybe. So if we have a look at that, the last 3 day moving average is clearly 20, so it's obviously picking up the right values. Let's enter 10, 55. If I was to select these, those average 55. They sum to 550. So there we go, moving averages from the bottom. You could also do moving averages from the top, wherever you want, using the offset function, the count, and the average. You've been looking at ExcelExperts.com.